Hi YouTubers, welcome to my video, and today I've got Chevrolet Orlando. I'm going to change the oil filter and I'm just gonna show you what you should not do, because this is what happens to me and I didn't know this before. So I've got this Chevrolet Orlando. Also it does use a Vauxhall Zafira engine, because all of them, they are GM cars. And the oil filter has a plastic cap. It's actual plastic. So I did try to use a pipe wrench, which didn't work. You can see here it is 24 mil. It did not work because it was so tight. I believe the previous owner did tight it, or maybe from the garage, so you couldn't remove it. And I went on to buy these tools. You can see different price and plus delivery, because same day delivery, it cost me a lot of money. I mean, you could see the price there, and then plus delivery. So roughly I have used about £48 just to remove this oil filter. And when I use this 24 mil, and this is what happened. You can see that I broke the cap and I couldn't use the car anymore. So I did order the cap on eBay. It cost about £18. If you cannot find for Chevrolet Orlando, just use Vauxhall Zafira. So I break the cap, I remove this from inside. I did a very good cleaning inside there. To break this, you can use a screwdriver. You don't need to worry. I mean, it's gone already. The important thing is that don't break the metal part itself. So you just need to go around the plastic cap, as you can see, and just clean it after you have broken it. So this is my cap, as you can see from here, and I have used the pliers just to remove the remaining bit here, as you can see from the video. So just to let you know, guys, that if you have broken that, you don't need to worry. Just break it, because nothing is gonna go inside the oil filter there, as long as you are a bit more careful. And this kind of plastic, I mean, you don't get those small pieces. It just break exactly what you are trying to break, only big pieces. So I put this one back. Just make sure that you clean, make sure that you have removed everything inside. Put your fingers inside and feel it. After that, you can just go on and change your oil filter, as I've done it. So here I've finished removing it. I bought new cap, and now I'm just gonna show you how to change this oil filter. So this is the oil filter. Bought it from Eurocarpart. And this is the bit which goes inside the cap. You can see this is the new cap. So that part goes inside there. You'll hear the click and the oil, the rubber around it, and put it on the cap. You have done the job. So you can see that is my cap down there, and this is my oil filter. I'm just gonna put it back and try to tight it, but to be a little bit careful, because it's aftermarket anyway. So if it is the original one has broken, that means aftermarket they are much more fake. So this is where the oil filter goes. You can see it is clean, and I'm gonna put it back. So as I said from the beginning of this video, you need to be very careful, because it's a plastic and it's not very strong. If you're not sure, then bring it to the garage. But even if you bring it to the garage, it's gonna be the same thing, because they will try it and break it and say that it was so tight, you need to buy it. It happens to me before when I changed the brake, and they did break something else, and then they said because the car was old, so I have to pay for that myself from Halford. So guys, thank you very much, and if this video helps, please give it a thumb up, and please don't forget to subscribe.